Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is the part two of my Sephora wish list for this VIB Rouge. I keep saying VIB Rouge because I am VIB Rouge. So in part one, I did products I really wanted to try during the sale. And this is gonna be the Sephora repurchase video, products that I already love and I need a repurchase, I need a backup. Before I go through my list, if you're new, hello and welcome. Make sure you subscribe before you leave and that you're on notifications for future videos. Buckle up, and if you have any products that you're gonna repurchase, let me know because it might be a product that I haven't tried yet and I can add that to my tries list. Okay, without further ado, the first product is the Laura Mercier Translucent Loose Setting Powder. This stuff is amazing. I have tried so many setting powders out there, but this one is like the most refined and it really helps when you set your concealer. Like, it does not crease at all. That plus shape tape, done. Amazing under eyes, no dark circles, no creasing, love it. So the next product is the Urban Decay D-Slick Oil Control Makeup Setting Spray. I love Urban Decay Setting Spray. My makeup won't move. I use that for my wedding. I danced my ass off. I had my wedding outside and it lasted like before like the ceremony and reception started, and that stuff did not move. Yes, love it. If you have not tried it out yet, you are missing out. If you don't believe me, ask Catherine. I got her hooked. And she can be a little tough to convince when it comes to makeup, and I'm like, told you so. Love you, girl. The next product is a beauty blender. Get a beauty blender. You get 20% off. It's $16 now instead of $20. A little cheaper. Or you get like the little bundle that's online where you get two beauty blenders and like the liquid cleanser. Amazing deal. The next product is a Becca Opal highlighter. Becca highlighters are some of my favorite highlighters. Opal is just a staple in your collection. I love Jaclyn Hill's Champagne Pop. I love Prosecco as well. I can't go wrong with the Becca highlighter. They're just so pretty. It's not glitter. It's actual pigments. The next product are Tarte Amazonian blushes. Oh, so good. Tarte has some of like the best blushes. They're definitely like my favorite. And they have so many shades. I really like just neutral shades. Like one like right here and I have on my cheeks right now. And this is the shade Unstoppable. Because I am unstoppable. This is like a travel size and it's still a decent size that I can just take with me on the go or just in general. I know around the holidays they come out with their blush palettes and oh my gosh, I feel like I need to get one every year, but you get such a great variety that you're just like obligated to get one. Just cannot get enough. The next product is a Benefit Hoola Matte Bronzer. It is not too light, it's not too dark, and they are very buildable. They're very easy to work with. I like to use mine with a Morphe E34 brush, and I think you could probably use it for the blush as well. You can put just very little on, you can do a whole look. I'm sure you can contour with this as well. Love it, love it, love it. The next product is the Too Faced Just Peachy palette. This palette has really grown on me and I've been taking it on travel with me recently just because of like the neutral shades, but I can add a pop of color. I can go a little bit bold. They're just very easy to blend. I feel like you don't have to put as much like effort into blending and it smells good. It's a very versatile palette. The next product is a palette and it's the Tarte Toasted palette. I jokingly bought this palette because I was honestly gonna pass on it because I had just bought the Urban Decay Heat palette because they're very similar. It was a joke at my wedding that we were toasted. I kept saying I'm toasted, we're all toasted. I don't know where that came from, but I kept saying it. So when that palette released, I was like, you know what? I'm gonna buy it. And I fell in love. I love the shimmer shades that they had in the Toasted palette. And I'm almost hitting pan on a few of them. And I have no regrets buying it. Tarte's eyeshadows are some of like the best eyeshadows. The next products are the Violet Voss Like a Boss and Hashtag palettes. It's a brand that I always wanted to try. For a brand to expand at a huge chain like Sephora or Ulta is so incredible, not just for the brand, but also as a consumer. I have fallen in love with Violet Voss eyeshadows. First of all, like when you get one of their palettes, the pan size is huge. I was just like shook with just the formula of them. There were just so many looks in their palettes that I can make as well. They do a really good balance of neutral shades to add a little bit pop of color. Really, really love these. And I know I'm gonna run out of these. I use them quite often, just haven't unpacked these yet. The next product is the Urban Decay Eyeshadow Primer Potions. Man, this is like an OG staple. Man, I just remember using that when I first started using makeup and wearing it. I was like, man, this stuff ain't going nowhere. The next product is the Lancôme Booster XL Super Enhancing Mascara Primer. Oh my god, I remember first trying this product. All I remember is applying it, I'm like, why are my eyelashes white? Like, mascara is not white. And then when I read over it, I was like, oh, duh. So I put mascara over it, and I was like, oh my gosh, look at my lashes. I have lashes. I just remember just having like that really shocked look on my face. The next product is the Urban Decay Perversion Eyeliners. I use a lot of eyeliner. Shout out and throwback to your emo days of black eyeliner, just top, bottom. I still do that sometimes. I don't know why people hate on it, but I love it. Classic look. And Perversion was definitely like the best eyeliner for my lower lash line that didn't smudge or budge, and I just come back to it all the time. For a while, I lost my pencil sharpener, so now that I have my sharpener, I will buy a Perversion one just because I missed it and it's bae. The next product is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Gel. I love this stuff. At first, when I first tried brow gel after filling in my brows, I'm like, why are they crusty? And I realized I just wasn't fully applying it properly. I was just kind of like slabbing it on. I had a dumb moment. Now that I know how to properly use it, I love it. And my brows go nowhere. I could be sweating, I could be swimming, I could be getting rained on, and my brows are going nowhere. The next product, the Laura Mercier Extreme Matte Lipstick. I loved it so much. For a matte, it wasn't drying at all. It was actually like the opposite. My lips can dry out really, really quickly. I just don't want crusty lips. No. So to find a good matte lipstick, because some matte solid lipsticks will dry out my lip, but this one didn't. The next product is the Too Faced Melted Matte Lipstick. I love this formula. My favorite shade is Lady Balls. It is like the perfect red, and that liquid lipstick formula does not dry out my lips. Enough said. Love it. Try it. So good. The next product is the Too Faced Peach Kiss Matte Lipsticks. I got these on one of those Sephora Weekly Wows, and they're very smooth. My lips don't feel dried out. They feel comfortable. All right, so that's it for makeup. There might be a few products that I forgot. These are the ones that just came to my head and I wrote them all down. The next category is gonna be skincare. So the first product is the Tatcha H2, oh wait, I think I wrote H2O for water, but it's the Tatcha Water Cream. Oh my gosh, I love Tatcha so much. Thank you, Mom, for introducing me to this brand and spoiling me with Tatcha. And then when I go buy Tatcha myself, I look at the price and go, Mom ruined me, but I love Tatcha. It is such a good brand. Very gentle. It's one of Sephora's clean brands. Tatcha, I believe, is Japanese skincare, and it is just so soft on my face. So hydrating. Doesn't leave you greasy. Doesn't leave you oily. The next product is the Sunday Riley UFO Ultra Clarifying Oil. I brag about this oil all the time. It has a very unique scent to it, and when I first tried it on, I was just like, ugh. But I love it. After I apply it, I'm like, Griffin, you cannot kiss my face. This is $80 oil. I do want to try the Luna oil. I mentioned that in my previous video, so let me know the pros and cons of the UFO oil and the Luna oil. The next product is the Kate Somerville Exfoliate. Oh my gosh, so I just recently started using this product and it is game changing. It was my first time trying the brand Kate Somerville as well, and it's a very good first experience. Very pleased how it worked. Very gentle exfoliator. It left my face super smooth when I applied my cleanser after exfoliating. Oh my gosh, my face was like baby butt smooth. I was just shook. The next product is the Murad Time Release Acne Cleanser. This stuff is so good, and keep going back to it because it is a great acne product. I'm an adult and I thought acne would go away, and it's not going away, and should I be concerned? All my friends still have it too, and I'm just like, I thought this was supposed to end a couple years ago, and here we are. So if you're having the same issue as me, try the Murad Cleanser and let me know how it works out for you. The next product is the Fresh Black Tea Kombucha Facial Treatment. Oh my gosh. So when this product first came out, I was like, oh, this looks awesome. And then I looked at the price, but I took the plunge during the last 20% off event that Sephora had. Man, it has been, it's game changing. You apply it before you put on your moisturizers and your serums and your oils, and it helps absorb it. You're not just forever just trying to get it in and soaking it in. It does the job for you. It has about 5-star rating. Fresh has been a brand that's growing on me recently. Oh, and their toner. Oh my gosh, their toner that have like actual like flower petals in it. It is so good too. I forgot about it until like I found like a bottle when I unpacked and there was like this much left. That's another one I would like to repurchase as well. The next product is the, I don't know how to say this name, Laneige Water Sleeping Mask. You literally put this on at the very end after your skincare routine at night, and the mask does everything overnight. It helps turn over your cells. You wake up refreshed and really smooth skin. Not like greasy, not like oily. Really impressed with that brand. That was my first and only product I've tried. The next product is the Ole Henriksen Eye Gel. This stuff, oh my gosh, love this stuff. It has been game changing. It's been really helping keeping my under eyes hydrated. It also helps brighten as well. The next product is the Philosophy Purity Made Simple Face Wash. Love this stuff. So I like to double cleanse at night. I usually use an oil-based product first, and then I follow it with the Purity Made Simple because it's just so gentle. And that's why I love the Purity, and I feel like it really gets in the gunk. I like to use it with my Clarisonic. Purity has been such a staple in my collection for a while now. The next product is the Tatcha Deep Cleanse Oil Cleanser. So I used to use their Sensitive for dry skin. It just depends how I'm feeling. Both work really well. This one is a couple dollars cheaper, so that's a plus. But this is like I said, the oil cleanser that I would use before Purity. Oil cleanser just feels so good after you exfoliate. And I don't know if you're supposed to exfoliate before or after you cleanse. Let me know what you do in the comments below. For me, logically, it makes sense to do an exfoliator first because you exfoliate all the dead skins, the dirt, the debris that your face has been exposed to all day, and then go with the cleanser. Like you're using like a clean slate then. But I always see people using a cleanser first then exfoliate, so I'm confused. Questions that need answers. Asking for a friend. Okay, and then the last skincare product, it's the Ole Henriksen Walnut Scrub. Again, Megan. She actually gave me a sample of this when I saw her. Oh my gosh, I made sure to conserve that little sample, but it was just so, so good. Talk about an exfoliating experience. So, in this order, use that Walnut Scrub, use that Tatcha Deep Cleanse Oil, use that Purity Made Simple, moisturize, do your oil, done. What a good nutshell. I still need to do my nighttime skincare routine, so I might break it down in a more visible way in a future video. So that's it for skincare. I have a few hair products. So the first product is the Briogeo Co-Wash. This has been a game changer for me because most two-in-ones dry out my hair, makes it very brittle, very coarse, but the Co-Wash does the opposite. You know, I don't wash my hair every single day. You know, if I do want to wash it every day, I'll just substitute for this. And the second product is the Briogeo mask, and it is awesome. I got like the big jumbo size the last time they had it, VIB Rouge sale. I like to put in my mask, shave my legs, enjoy my bath, and then rinse it out. I feel like you can't overdo it with a hair mask, especially with as much hair as I have. You can clean the house with the mask and then just rinse out your hair. Don't tell me I live my life. And then the next product is the Olaplex Hair Repair number 3 product. So good. This was the only product that was on Sephora's website at the time. Now they have a shampoo and conditioner, and it helps your dead ends and your split ends, and it also helps moisturize. You can use it as like a styling treatment. How I use it is I get out of the shower and I kind of just put some in, brush my hair. But if I am straightening my hair the next day, I can definitely see a difference in how soft my hair is because it definitely has like that silky texture to it. It takes a lot for my hair to feel really silky because there's just a lot of it. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Let me know if you have similar products on your list. Let me know what products you're gonna repurchase. Always, always open to trying out new products. But I appreciate your love and support on this video. Make sure you're subscribed to stay tuned for future content. See you in the next video.